maybe this video won't get took down because, yeah, they don't take too kindly to you having to show everybody what's the problem. Well then, now they have that figured out. Now that I have to this is winning. Oh, I need somebody to hold the flashlight for me. What am I doing? This is like, you can like lease you a vehicle. Or you can do what country people do. Christmas. This is winning. This is like, makes all your dreams come true. You know, I'm just glad. I'm just glad, you know. I can work on it. My whole life to do this. mean, I mean, you're going to drive you a Ford, you better have all the tools. You better have a complete set. That's what I love. That's particularly what I love the most right here. You know, a ratchet won't fit on it. I love getting greasy, like right here. I ain't even touched nothing but this bar. See, that's the kind of stuff I love. Thank God I'm a country boy. You just fix it all right here, you know. Where it lay. That is not easy to turn. Man, note to self, like, if you work on something, might want to pressure wash the bolts in the area before you get on it, because I'm talking about, am I going to make it or what? Yeah. That was a game changer there. All right, that's the hot wire. Get it out of the way. Got to have a deep well now. Ask me why it's a Ford, but it's a metric bolt on the starter. Figure that one out, let me know. Y'all still with me? Y'all still with me, ain't you? They make this about impossible to get to. It's just beyond me. Is not going on there. bolt ain't even tight. That's two. There's a third bolt on that, I guarantee you. Yep, up there in the Mission Impossible place. Yeah. I don't want. That's why it gets so greasy. Like rubbing everything. See the boat. That's winning. That. Thank you. I mean, I can't even see the dang boat. And my hands don't fit in anywhere in this truck. Come on, baby. Where are you at? But how are you supposed to get your hands in something like this to fix, to even work on it? There's the press on it right there. For the win. Oh, it's like, it's up top. The wrench won't even go in it. I mean, what in the world? I think I'm on it, but there ain't no way in the world a socket's gonna go on that. I know what you need is a swivel. I wish I could say like mechanic and turn me on, but it never has. Like I can do it, but I don't enjoy it. I'm never just like, yeah, I enjoyed that. I think I want to do that again tomorrow. Like, I'm going to pass on that. Like, I'm going to pass on all that. So what I'm doing is taking the starter off a Ford because, you know, that's just a common problem with a Ford. You shut it off and it don't crank back up and don't even have a reason. Because it just decided that the starter decided that's the last time it was ever going to turn over and crank. So then they designed it to where it's got three bolts in it. And, you know, when they designed it, they was like, hey, let's put that top bolt up there where they can't hardly nobody get it, where they sure can't see it. They can feel it, but they ain't getting it. So that's kind of what's going on right now. Yeah, so I got to get the starter off, but I got to have a swivel. Because you can't get to it. So yeah, that's what's happening right this minute. This is me like putting off, getting out from under here. Going to my toolbox again and hunting for a swivel. Like, I know I got swivels, but far as like why I'm live, let's go find a swivel. Yeah, it don't usually happen that way. I don't know why, but it never happens like, oh, there it is, you little guy. Yeah, it never does. Never in the history of ever have you ever just walked over and you was like, there it is, found it. Yes, you know, I want to touch everything that's greasy. I want to touch everything that's greasy while I'm doing this, because that's what every Ford man says. They like, hey, you want to go, I probably can't take the wheel off, but, you know, buddy's like, hey, you want to go riding? It's like, if we're taking your truck, let's Let's bring the toolbox with us. Let's do that. Every day, I found one. Found one. Let's try this again. Yeah. I might do it this time. Try it again. You gotta be that aggravating. Why? I mean, why? How's that even possible? I was on it. I don't know how that happened. Man, I should have just kept going. I can't even get my fingers on it. Should have just turned it a few more times when I had it on. This is ridiculous. Dang, that scared me. Come on, baby. Get on there. Thank you. That's winning, boy. What I'm going through. There ain't enough. There just ain't enough to tell it. You need a swivel to get to it, but you also need a personal assistance to hold the swivel. I mean, like, you can't even see it. You just have to feel for it. Ridiculous stuff ever. I mean, that's ridiculous. A standard wrench won't fit American-made truck. What is that? That's hot. that was hot. I gotta have that. My fella's like a 10. My arms is just burnt slap out, like, wee-hoo. I mean, just holding my arm over my head's a job. That was ground. That's hot. Hot's got two legs. All right. I'm talking about, yeah, does it feel better? You reckon? I sure hope it does. I just want to complain. If your man owns a Ford, buy him a tub of wipes. He don't even know he needs them. He'll be thanking you, you know. What going on? Thank you. We gotta do all this just to be able to tote it without getting greasy. Yeah, my truck won't crank. It ain't. It's been sitting here for about 3 weeks, I believe. I come over here to play some music at my house and like went to get in the truck. It wouldn't crank. So I'm gonna go to town and get a starter. I gotta get y'all wiped up. You know? That's winning. You gonna throw that shirt away. Lord, I got a mess. Blowing the horn. I just said it right there. I'm coming. Thank you. Starter. Sorry, I know that ain't ideal. Me holding the camera, but
like you got. You better look out now.
That's another shake. That's what it. That's what keeps your body going. Can't sit down because it's wet right here. I want to find Johnny Cash. I mean, that's winning. Hey, look here, y'all. I've been had a drive to town. I might let y'all go because I ain't doing the whole green screen thing like it ain't gonna fly today. But I appreciate you watching and thank you for the likes and the thumbs ups and the shares. And thank y'all, okay? Bye-bye. All right. Y'all hang on. I see June, but I don't see Johnny. See if I see. Hey, baby. I don't know, kind of unusual he's not with her. Say always together. Have y'all onion ring here. Hey, the starter's messed up. I'm going to buy a starter. But I got to say the blessing. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for another beautiful day. Thank you for an opportunity to get spread your word. Thank you for the food. Thank you for the beautiful people that tune in to watch, and all the love that's given and kindness. And just want to say thank you for it. And we just want to say that we love you with all our hearts. And I hope you have a good day. Amen. My hands is a little dirty. They're a lot better than they was.
I got to go to town, y'all. It's a little aggravating. I called the school. A little aggravating trying to hold this tablet.
Say Johnny Cash this way. I'm gonna look this direction.
ain't like him to be gone.
I don't know, maybe he's in the woods. I just find it hard to believe he's away from June, because they like stick together like a champ. I hope this starter is what's wrong with it. What's wrong with my truck, because it won't crank by the key and it won't crank jumping it off at the solenoid. Fire going to the starter, so and this thing right here. Yeah, you're right. Kind of like when one eye really went missing. So to get that starter off that top, look, you gotta go between the chassis and the manifold. You gotta have a 1 foot extension with a swivel. And it is not fun. You can't even see where the hole is. You can't even see the bolt. That's like, see, country boys,
like somebody just leave that boat off
because how hard it is to get to. The sun is rough.
I mean, the sun ain't even
out, but it's like, tearing me up. I love driving in fifth when I'm pulling out. It's like, who got time to shift, you know? Who got time to downshift? Feel better driving behind me, seeing me turn around.
Yeah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. This is yours.
Okay.
I got you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you, sir. 01 F-150 starter.
What engine you got now?
It's a 5.4, four-wheel drive. You got a way to check this one?
I do not.
I didn't know if it had a core or not, so I brought it. I guess that, I don't know what kind of plug that is, but this one didn't have it. It was missing.
It's just a little apple water bit.
Yeah. It wouldn't, it wouldn't turn over. It just clicked under the hood. And I could put a screwdriver on a solenoid up there to like bypass the switch. Uh-huh. Still wouldn't turn over. But I had fire going to it like a champ, so.
Did you try jumping it off or anything like that?
No.
Yeah. Make sure all your cable connections are good.
Well, I mean, I had fire going to it like a, I had good fire going to it.
Okay.
So. I didn't check nothing else. I just said, well, this got to be the starter. And that top bolt right here.
Was it loose?
No. Like I never got it off.
Oh.
You can't even see it.
Yeah.
You barely can get a finger on it to find it.
Yep. Yeah, well, the old ones were like that, too. And I used to have a, well, I still do. I got an extension that's about that long because you couldn't get right onto them a lot of times with a ratchet, back off of them. So I would get that extension, and it was about that long with a flex socket on the end.
Yep.
And yeah, you just feel the bolt, and then you catch it, and that's it.
Yeah, like it was eventful. That's what I did. I went between the chassis and the manifold.
Yeah.
They build these things.
They don't
think about the
mechanics. They don't. Yeah, my hand don't fit through most places. So aggravating. Talking about, I ain't never liked mechanica. I do it all. I just complain when I'm doing it. And then when I'm done, I'm happy. But it don't mean I enjoy doing it.
156.59
all yet. Is the reader over there?
Okay.
Oh.
Yeah, that might work on it.
Thank you.
See y'all later.
All right, take care.
I'm right. $150-something, yep. Could have been worse. Could have not had it.
Roof at back there, they just put a roof on it last week. I seen them. They ain't putting no flash in. That's gonna leak. Man, I didn't even see him walking in the road. He blended in. Ready to get this Ford going. I've been driving my diesel everywhere. We
It's just fine. It's got air conditioning. Like, it rides good, drives good. It don't turn very well. That's because it's like an Ugly. But like, when you fill this thing up with fuel, it's like $135. I fill my gold truck up, it's about, I don't know, about $65 or so like that. I don't always like changing gears. Like, I heard my daddy talking about that. He said you get tired of changing gears. Sometimes you just want to get in and drive. Old time just flies, don't it? Time just flies. Tell you, we fished yesterday. We fished yesterday for 12 hours, and then we drove about 4.5 hours on top of fishing for 12 hours. And I am just like not over it. I'm just not over it yet. And I went to sleep early. I'm talking about like 12:00, and I don't feel like I slept none. Something just smacks fire out of the side of my truck. I seen a drill laying beside the road this morning when I took Bentley to school. Like a battery impact drill. I didn't pick it up. Well, for one thing, I know it wasn't mine. But I see it was gone. Somebody picked it up because it was gone. good man. See if I see him at the pins. Oh, gone, look at that. I'm about to have some frogs like a champ. That was frogs.
in the making. Oh man, that makes me feel better. That worried me. Johnny Cash is over here. Man, I ain't never seen them separated. Johnny Cash, boy, you scared me. Johnny Cash. Never seen them get separated like that. He's over there just strutting the stuff. Dobby, what are you doing, Dobby? Dobby. It's amazing to me how they staying in their chicken houses. I mean, there's a lot of them running around. They like everywhere, really. But it's amazing how many's like staying just staying in the coops. What are you doing, Jack Sparrow? What are you doing? Jack Sparrow, do you like all your run around room? Come here. Dobby. Come here, Dobby. What are you doing? What are you doing? You a pretty boy, ain't you? You a pretty boy, ain't you? What are you doing? You stretching? Are you smelling the air? There ain't no love in the air here, there, homie. Hate to hurt your feelings. Yeah! Y'all having a good time? What was that? That better be a yes, sir. We having a good time? Dobby. Don't y'all want to come work on a Ford? Don't y'all want to come work on the truck and I'll go play in the pen? I heard that. Yeah. I'm gonna move my camera to over here. So I got the camera watching this. See, I don't know what this is from. I didn't do that. I don't know if something's climbing the gate or what, but this, that I didn't do. Didn't do this neither. I mean, I guess it could be chickens jumping up there, but I got my camera gonna be watching it and we'll know. Oh, I see deer. I see deer running through that field right there. Yep. Dobby, you pretty man. What am I supposed to say? What am I supposed to do? Now, what are y'all all doing out now? Y'all ain't even supposed to be out. And I was looking everywhere for you. Johnny, you had me worried, man. If June finds out you over here entertaining the women, folks, you in trouble. Just gonna tell you now. That's what I've been looking for right there. Something definitely got my chicken, because that's what I've been looking for. There's feathers. You need to get back in the pen. guess I know that now. Need to set me a trap back here. How do you wet your pants when you got boots on? Yeah, I'll be looking for, I want to get me one of them Great Pyrenees or get two of them. But I got too many irons in the fire, you know? First, I had to get my priorities in order. I got my priorities in order. I mean, so much for like sitting on the porch in my underwear. So there's that. Yeah, that's not your land. That's how long it takes to burn the arm out. That's the ground. That's the hot. Ugh. baby. What's the deal? Gotta take a neck break. I wish I could just describe how my arms feel. They have burnt slap out. Something fell in my eye, it just keeps getting better. Oh, there it is. Well then. That's wonderful. A little dirt never hurt, you know? Except for when it's in your eye. I can't tell if it's out or not. think it is. Hey, somebody riding on both sides. Such a butthole. I mean, I love just hearing a four-wheeler. Thank you. Working.
You hard at it?
Yeah.
I was going to stop by and tell you, I accidentally hit one of your little lights out there.
All right, that's cool.
But I will replace it for you.
I got some more, brother. It's all right.
We're out here trying to figure out some lines, trying to draw some plans. But I was going to let you know.
I've been there.
Yeah. Have you talked with that David fellow that bought that land over there? Griffey.
I've just spoke to him a couple times.
We met with him last week because we're talking about swapping some land around with him. Oh. Because there's only 100 feet between y'all. It's ours. We're talking about giving him that back corner up back there for 100 feet more of this strip up here so he can ride close to the road.
Oh, I heard that.
Because we're around where our driveway's going to be, and it rides right through the middle of that, right through the corner of that bottom back there.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just going to be a fucking problem.
Yeah. So, it's wet, too.
It is very wet. It's gotten higher since last weekend.
Yeah.
But, anyhow.
What square footage is your house?
It's 1512.
I'll pick up where we want to start.
Yeah. Well, everything went good until I got to the electric part, and I can't get the electrical people to show up. Been waiting for 3 weeks.
Everything else was good.
Yeah, I did it all. I had a couple buddies to help me. Hang the rafters and the porch joists, but I did most of it myself. I appreciate it.
The foundation
shit? I hired a concrete, some guys to do the block work.
Yeah.
Now, my buddy dug the footer and poured it, but the block guys done the block work. I didn't want to mess with that.
All right, man, where's my sweet guy here? I just want to let you know I
actually
hit that light.
Yeah, that's cool, bro.
All right, dude. We'll see you around.
All right. I didn't know that was him. I mean, I didn't know he had been got on the other side. I didn't know y'all had died, sorry. So that was a guy that bought the land beside me, but he only owns 100 feet wide. He owns 100 feet wide, and then, back. And then he can't get to his part of the land without crossing my part of the land because there's a swamp. And the dam is like on my property. So, so there's that. But I mean, I'm not a butthole. I'm not like, I'm not the type like, hey, what are you doing? You know? You're a good neighbor. State Farm is here.
never heard it doing what it's doing right now. So what the problem is, I put my starter in and it's binded up. The teeth ain't going into the flywheel. So I guess I got it on there a little off. Had to take it back off. Cause it's turning on and spinning, but it ain't going into the groove of the flywheel. Crap, I done got the battery cable on.
I gotta go take the battery cable off. That's what you don't want to do. I despise doing this. I'd rather have my tail whooped than do this. This is complete and utterly ridiculous. I'm sorry, this is ridiculous.
Just another day in paradise.
Paradise?
Yep.
Man, that's nice. Can I speak freely?
I'm live.
Oh, okay. Then I won't. So much. Hey, at least you got room to work. I put the track back up.
Oh, okay.
It didn't work out. He could go in there and get stuff and leave.
Damn.
So now I got a new trick for him.
Well, I gotta put it out because I got something getting chicken. Something got a chicken last night.
I put it right by the light pole, brother.
Okay.
Yeah, I got me about 22 rats out.
Mm-hmm.
I guarantee he won't trip that.
This is the stupidest. This is the stupidest stuff I've ever seen.
Why you say that?
Bolt from a Ford starter.
Metric.
Well, that too.
Well, everything on the truck should be metric. Not trying to be
funny. Well, I got the tools.
You know why they made metric sockets? And I'm being honest. Well, you know, when people say, give me a half inch, they'll give me one up from a half inch because they don't know how to read them. Measurement, 8/16, 8/4, 5/16, you know what I'm saying? So they say, let's make some wrenches. It's called 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. This one don't work, get them next one up. What you got? I got a 12, that'd be a 13.
It's called wrenches for dummies. Actually, I think it was a Japanese or...
What? No, we do standard. Other countries do metric. But anyway, I was going to tell you, I brought that back.
I bolted the starter up and it's turning, but it ain't clicking in the flywheel.
What?
Yeah. It's spinning.
How's that possible?
I mean, hey, beats all I ever seen.
So you saying the motor, are you saying the Bendix is going out, but the starter ain't spinning?
I'm saying I done bolted the starter up and crunk it, and all it did was spin. It ain't kicking in the flywheel. So I'm trying to loosen the bolts up to just like take it off and just put it right back on again.
I don't know how many starters you ever dealt with, but have you ever seen a starter that would go wing but the motor wouldn't engage? That's because the starter ain't no good, but the Bendix is still turning the motor over. It's not pushing the gear head.
They don't understand, it's brand new. Just went and bought it.
Hey, they make bad ones too, buddy. I hate to tell you that, they do. Everything that's made can be junk. I mean, they gotta make bad ones too, you know. They can't all be good, bro.
So if it's bolted up and it's flush, it's in the flywheel.
It's in the flywheel.
Actually, I don't even think.
The head shouldn't engage till
that's right.
It drives it forward. Now, the motor can spin and the Bendix is not driving it forward and it wouldn't engage the flywheel.
Well, then I ain't worried about the flywheel being kinked because that's right. I forgot about that.
Yeah.
It don't engage in the flywheel till it shoots it forward.
That's right. Because if it did, you couldn't be running 5,000 RPM and you started on. You'd sling that rascal apart, you know. But, I mean, hey, are you getting enough bolts to it? I mean, is your battery fully charged? Is it? Like,
I guess that's the question of the day.
You know, it could be weak, and I mean, I don't sound to me like the Bendix is not pushing the drive motor right. But I don't know. Here, let me hook the battery up and spin it over.
I'm gonna get the wires back on it.
Oh, well, you can't spin it over with wires off. I'm going to go to town and get my brother's impact and do my hubs today or tomorrow.
My impact's on the porch right there.
What? Basically, what you're telling me is you can save me a trip to town. That's the plan of my brother. Get a dang gun, what nobody sees.
after the third piece of dirt in my eye, you think I'd go get some glasses.
After the second one, yes, sir, I'll agree. That's usually how I do it. After the first one, I'll put on my glasses. But I'm stubborn, and I'll do the first one without knowing, you know. But after the first, second, yeah, it's definitely time. You seen your fox anymore?
Yeah, he's still around. This went in the pen and got a chicken.
What?
Yeah.
So it's time for us to relieve him of his breathing issues. They say when a fox starts eating chickens, he has respiratory problems.
Well, I don't know that it's a fox. Something went through the fence. Something either climbed the fence or went through it. Had nothing dug in it. No, because it took it through the back of the fence and went through that pasture.
Oh, okay. I know at night, you know, an owl can get them.
Well, I mean, it could have been.
An owl will get chicken. As long as it ain't no big chicken. I don't think they kill a big chicken. A small one. Like them white ones you got, I don't think an owl will kill them. But I don't get paid to think, so don't listen to me. They're all an animal of opportunity. Whatever they can kill and eat, that's what they kill and eat. You wouldn't think a fox like chicken eggs. God, they do. You gonna keep it off again?
It's ready to try.
You got your wires on?
I ain't got the battery cable on.
I ain't do nothing but take the wire off. Put it back on. But if it does, it just spins over, it could actually be the Bendix. I'm not trying to make money now. They make new bad stuff too, you know. I've seen old boy on TikTok, he bought a brand new Sierra, got 8 miles on it, slung pistons out of the motor. 6.2 liter LS. I was like, ain't no way. And he showed the speedometer and it had 8 miles on it. Slung the pistons out of the motor. Like, would a warranty have fixed that? Well, you ain't really lost nothing. They'll put you in. It's a brand new truck. I paid $100,000. I was like, God, $100,000. It went 8 miles. That's not good. Okay. Let me get out of the way. Yep. That don't sound right. It sounds like the motor turning, but it ain't pushing the gear drive up. You know what I mean?
I appreciate y'all watching. I got to go to the house and get my jump box. Take this off. I don't know what. But anyhow, appreciate y'all watching. I don't even know what time it is. 2:40. Yeah. Appreciate it. Y'all have a good day, okay? Alrighty, bye-bye now.
Thank you. Got a bad spot on your flywheel?